Fans of George R.R. Martin's Fire and Ice series and the HBO show Game of Thrones know two things. One, don't get too attached to any of the characters. Two, weddings aren't always happy occasions.
Okay, folks, obligatory spoiler alert if you have not caught up to the latest episode of Game of Thrones. So at his wedding, King Joffrey dies from a particularly nasty poison, the Strangler. There's no need to argue about whether or not the little punk deserved it, but instead, let's talk about exactly what this poison is. Chemist Rachel Burks at Doane College in Nebraska has done a little research and might have some leads as to what this rare and deadly poison can be made out of.
Now, three plants have been featured quite a lot in both fictional and non-fictional murder plots. That would be belladonna, also known as deadly nightshade, poison hemlock, and to round out our trio of usual suspects, Strychnos nox vomica, also known as the strychnine tree. Now, all three of these plants share something in common. They all make alkaloids.
In general terms, alkaloids are naturally occurring compounds that share the same basic chemical structure. They've all got at least one nitrogen atom in a heterocyclic ring. Here are three deadly alkaloid suspects. In Martin's mythology, the Strangler causes the muscles in a person's neck to clench together tighter than a fist, so tight that air can't pass through the windpipe, causing the victim to asphyxiate. So, do any of these three alkaloids share a common characteristic with the Strangler?
Well, let's take a look at the first two members of our poisonous trio, belladonna and hemlock. Now, these two do affect our muscles. They cause your muscles to relax.
So that leaves us with just strychnine.
10 to 20 minutes after you've injected a lethal dose of strychnine, you're going to start feeling your muscles convulse. Now, which muscles? Ah, here's the really interesting part. The strychnine also affects the muscles in the face and the neck first. That kind of fits in with how Martin has described the Strangler as causing the muscles in a man's neck to clench up.
This makes a pretty good match, but there are some details that need to be covered before we can be sure. Martin writes that the Strangler is made from the leaves of a plant on an island in the Sea of Jade, half a world away, and that that poison is extracted from these leaves using a wash of lime and then treated with a wash of sugar. It's true that strychnine can be found in the leaves of a plant, but what about this wash of lime? Is this a practical way of getting the poisonous alkaloids out?
What if Martin doesn't mean limes as in the fruit? He means limes as in a limestone product, calcium oxide. This type of lime is very alkaline. It's very basic, it has a high pH. And this type of lime has been used as part of a multi-step extraction technique to get alkaloids out of plants.
And again, what about this sugar? Is it really necessary?
Strychnine, like a lot of alkaloids, has a very bitter taste. It doesn't taste good. So we might need sugar and spices to disguise the taste of strychnine. Cause if you're trying to poison someone, you don't want them to know that usually.
So just like everyone's favorite alkaloid, caffeine, strychnine is definitely in need of a little sweetness. And it looks like we've got a pretty good match for Martin's deadly strangler. It may very well be that strychnine is a poison that took down King Joffrey. Click here for a bonus video that explains how a single compound can be made a medicine in one dose, but a murder weapon in another, as well as Rachel's thoughts on combining pop culture with chemistry. Thanks for tuning in, folks. If you got any ideas for reactions episodes, let us know in the comments. But in the meantime, we've got some good stuff coming up this month, so stay tuned. We'll see you again soon.